Ozark is a show on Netflix that was on everybody's home screen, but I feel as though not that many people were talking about it. In fact, not enough people are talking about it. It's a show that follows Marty Bird and his troubled life after he's been caught out cheating the Mexicans with regards to laundering their money. His family moved to the Ozark and has to launder a load of money before his time runs out and somehow find a way to get around all of the curveball threats that he faces along the way. Should you invest 20 hours worth of your time watching this show? Let's find out. Before I go ahead, make sure you go over to my Twitter @brainpilot_ and drop me a follow so you can vote on what the next video I do is. Have your say. So without further ado, I'm Brain Pilot, and here is Ozark. Is it worth watching? I'll keep this as spoiler-free as possible. The story. Marty Bird and a load of his money laundering pals have been stealing from the Mexicans, and he's in deep trouble. All of his friends get killed, and he manages to survive by saying that he can launder $8 million within a few months in this new place, which is called the Ozark, due to it having more of a shoreline than the whole of California. He encounters several problems along the way, such as his wife cheating on him and trying to withdraw all of their money to screw him over, interfering with huge drug dealers, losing the money he's supposed to launder, trying to find businesses to launder his money, and lots of times where his life has been moments away from being finished by the hands of somebody else. I think the story is really, really good. Many times I was watching it at 2 a.m. and had to constantly watch the next episode due to the fact I was so hooked. It's like Narcos, but without the subtitles, and instead of Colombians, it's Mexicans. However, I would say that the story at the start of season 1 was a lot better than the final episode. I felt as though the story was resolved, but not necessarily in the way in which I feel it would have best suited the show. The excitement, drugs, fighting, brutality, and intensity of the story is something that makes the show extremely enjoyable to watch, and you find yourself constantly guessing what is going to happen next, which in turn keeps you glued to the screen. Also, something that must be mentioned is the way in which the O at the start of the episode with the cross in gives you four symbols to look out for that relate to the story in that episode. It's great to watch, and it gives you a heads up about what's going to happen. It's a great touch. The characters. There are quite a few characters in the show, but I'm going to touch on the ones that you tend to follow the most. Marty Bird. Marty is the sort of character who, if you saw him on the street, you'd think he was a normal guy. But in reality, he is a dark character behind closed doors and is somebody that is a lot tougher than what you'd imagine. Despite that, I like how loyal he is to his family despite the troubles, and how he can always talk himself out of a problem. He loves his wife despite everything that she's done, and I like how as the problems get bigger and it escalates even more, it brings him closer to his family, and he's able to connect with them even more. He's somebody that you root for and want to survive. Also, I don't feel as though anybody would have given a better performance as this character other than Jason Bateman. His delivery is great. Wendy Bird. This is a character that you do not like. Even though she's Marty's wife, she's messed up, and the fact that she was prepared to leave him to essentially die in the first episode shows you the depth of her character. I don't feel as though she's got that much of a character arc or a journey that she goes on. She starts in the same position as she finishes, with Marty, despite not really wanting to be, I think. Ruth. Ruth is a character that you actually experience a change with. She starts as this dirt poor crook that is only out for herself, but the journey that she goes on allows you to go from hating her to actually being on her side and rooting for her 100%. You question certain decisions that she makes, but 9 times out of 10, you're on her side. Jacob and his wife. These characters get introduced to you partway through season 1, and they're interesting to watch. Jacob is somebody that you can buy into, and although you may not like him, the character's portrayal is great. His wife, on the other hand, is just annoying. She acts before thinking of the consequences, and it's something that I just didn't really believe. I don't believe that somebody that powerful and with that much authority would be that stupid to just do the things that she does and just get away with it. Cassimo. I thought Cassimo was an interesting character. The authority and presence that he had on the screen was second to none. He absolutely suited the leader type character, and despite never raising his voice or his temper being raised, as a viewer you understood that you shouldn't mess with him, and he's the last person that you want to annoy. He took the approach that less is more, and it definitely worked. Charlotte. Charlotte is somebody who you find yourself getting extremely frustrated with. One, she is 15, and you think, how is she getting away with all that she is at that age? And two, She goes against what her parents say a lot of the time, despite knowing how much trouble they are actually in. I don't quite understand why she does a lot of the things that she does, but she's not that dislikable, so it goes in her favor. One part that I didn't understand was when she was swimming in the lake and she pretended to drown. That really did confuse me. Its rating. IMDb have scored this show 8.4 out of a possible 10. So what does this tell us? It tells us that it's a good show. A really good show. However, it doesn't seem as though that many people are talking about it, and that's what really confuses me. It's a show that from the first episode, you were deep within it. With many shows, you find yourself taking a few episodes to settle in, but with this, you're there from the off. It's very similar to Narcos, with the drugs and the violence. However, I believe that this show is definitely better than Narcos. Final thoughts. Ozark is definitely a show that is worth watching. If you want to go on a journey with characters that go up and down, see violence on screen, have to guess what is coming next, and constantly question who is in the right, who is in the wrong, and think about whether or not they are making the right decision, then this is the show. It is one of the best things that I've seen on Netflix in a long while. I definitely recommend it. Ozark is worth watching. What did you think of Ozark? Did you enjoy it? Leave a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.